dog, just take a moment to drop your head and give it a good shake, yes and no. And to kind of like adjust your stance longer or wider or however which way you need to, so you can start to feel a little more stable and steady. And from a place of stability and steadiness, add a little fluidity, start to soften through your knees, your elbows, jaw. Good call. Take a breath in through your nose and open your mouth, let it wash out. That was so good. Let's do it again. Deep breath in through your nose. Hold it in this time. And then open your mouth, let it empty. Wait, one more time. Full this breath. Yes. Sip your breath in, hold it in, and then sip it even more so you're really full. And stick your tongue out, open your mouth. Yeah. Now ujjayi. Seal your lips together, breathe in and out through your nose. Yeah, and begin to engage through your core deeply. So we're going to work a lot of core today. So you want to think about your core as much more than just like that area around your belly button. You know, like, so it might start there with a hug to Uddiyana. But then get really active in your arms and in your legs. Really from fingers to toes. And then use your core to expand your breath. So from the hug of your belly, start to send your breath into your sides. There you go, into the front and the back of your body. And as you breathe in, roll out into a high plank, letting your shoulders arrive over your wrists. And feel free to put a knee or two down at any time to adjust your feet wider, give you more stability. But actively pull up from the floor. That's it, yeah, you're good. Take an inhale, and then down dog is your exhale. Press back, and as you do so, pull your belly in tighter. Okay, now keep the hug, and as you inhale, roll back into and as you exhale, press back into your dog, pulling in through core. Keep the hug, again, as you inhale, plank. And again, as you exhale, downward facing. And you'll do this a few more times on your own, starting to explore this connection. Let your breath be your main priority here. Your breath is going to serve as fuel. It's going to also help keep you calm and clear and focused. Three more. Hold the tail up. Yes, I know. Yeah, notice if your head's kind of heavy, if there's areas of droopiness anywhere, and keep thinking about lifting your body up from the ground. Last one. Good. Forward as you inhale into plank. And then back into your down dog as you exhale. And now take your right leg towards the ceiling. Keep your hips square to begin. Really good, really good. Now push down into your palms, almost like a plank, and pull everything else up from your wrists. Your armpits, your shoulders, your right heel and toes. But keep your leg as long as you can and just stack right hip over left. Mm-hmm. Don't bend your knee yet, don't bend your knee yet. Straighten your leg, stack right hip over left, and turn as much as you can your body open to the side of your mat. And now same thing, treat it like plank. Pull your body up from the ground, get your right heel as high as you can. Yeah, a little higher lift for your right heel. And now keep the height, bend your knees. Your knee stays lifted, your hip stays lifted. A good idea to drop your head really heavy here. Good, hug in Uddiyana, so maintain that connection to center. Take one more inhale. And now as you exhale, bring your right knee to your right shoulder. Rock forward, core plank, and your left knee can always be down. As you inhale, take your leg right back up. And as you exhale, go back to your right shoulder. Good, one more time, kick up as you inhale. And as you exhale, go to your right shoulder. Now right here, listen, push into the ground, pull up. Then as you inhale, slide your right knee down to your right wrist. Just do a hover. As you exhale, pull it back up. As you inhale, right knee to right wrist. As you exhale, pull it back up. Good, one more time each way. As you inhale, slide. As you exhale, lift. And now right shin to the floor, half pigeon. But instead of collapsing, I want you to just set your shin down, tuck your back toes, and pull in your thighs. Engage your mula, the root block of your body. Keep connected to your core. Your hands can stay down. One or two arms could lift if you wanted to check that connection to your core. Treat this as active and intentional. A few breaths. Looks good, you guys. Keep pulling up from the floor. The sides of your body long, your heart lifted. Take one more breath. And now as you exhale, put your hands on the ground,
Come back into core plank. Your right knee lifts up into your chest.
Good. Three-legged dog. Right leg up into the air. Bend your knee. Stack your hip. You might even flip your dog. Keep your breath fluid and free. Good. Lips together. Ujjayi. There you go. Connect. Pull your ribs in. Your belly in. Right. This is going to fuel your breath a little bit bigger by giving it some support.
Take one more inhale.
Then downward facing dog, come up and over. Ground hands, ground feet, and set your eyes. Maybe a breath in through your nose. You're welcome to open your mouth, stick your tongue out. Hear what you gotta clear. And now left leg straight up and back.
Yeah, hips square to begin.
Good. Treat it like a plank. Push into the ground and pull everything else up from it. Your right heel might even lift. Keep your breath steady and stack left hip over right. Leg stays straight, leg stays straight, leg stays straight. Wake up your toes, turn autopilot off, and keep bringing your breath in full. But now just like plank, keep lifted. Stay as high as you can with your hips and just let your knee bend. Your heel's gonna drop. Have a knee nice and high. Head good and low. Full Ujjayi flow. And if you ever notice that your breath is getting shallow or stagnant, know that usually it's a shift in the approach to the shape. So it might be your right forearm or knee on the ground, right? But take one more breath. Let it empty. And then re-square your hips. So your left leg straight up as you inhale. Then bring your left knee to your left shoulder as you exhale. Good. As you inhale, kick straight back and up. And as you exhale, right up to as high as you can, left shoulder. One more time. Kick up as you inhale. And high onto your left shoulder. Right from here, left knee to left wrist as you're inhale.
And then as you exhale, lift it back up.
As you inhale, down to your wrist.
As you exhale, lift it.
Good, one more time. Lower to your wrist.
Good, lift it up.
And then half pigeon variation. So you're putting your shin, your knee down, back knee to the ground, toes tucked. You don't have to lower your hips all the way. Instead, you want to hug your hips together. Engage Mula, Uddiyana, even your toes, all 10. And then hands can stay down or arms can lift. So it's active here.
Good, breathe into the sides of your body
and soften through your jaw, anywhere of unnecessary clenching or holding.
Good, ribs in.
There you go, heart a little higher, you might look up. Take one more breath. Then back to core plank. Plant your hands, tuck your back toes, pick your left knee up into your chest. Three-legged dog, left leg up, bend your knee. Stack and open, you might flip your dog, you might turn it into a kind of funky variation of a side plank.
Your tongue fall away from the top of your mouth so your cheeks are soft and breath is free. Good. Take one more. And we'll meet in Malasana, top of the mat.
So however many steps it takes, you'll make your way there.
Feet wide, hips low.
Your heels don't have to be touching the floor, but they could be. And now create that same sensation that you did in your pigeon of pulling your hips together.
Right, engaging Mula, Uddiyana,
and your arms might even float forward, right? Your arms might even reach up. Here you're again just kind of checking this connection to your core. Notice that your toes are death gripping the floor. Pick your toes up and just push into your bones. Keep pulling in your hips. Keep pulling in your thighs. Keep pulling in your belly. And then as you inhale, rise all the way up to stand. Welcome to look up. And as you exhale, lower right back down. Squeeze your hips in. Squeeze your belly in.
As you inhale, rise all the way up.
And as you exhale, lower right back down. Take three more. And if you're feeling very stable, you can start to pick your heels up and do this on the balls of your feet. You could keep your gaze up the entire time or close your eyes even. Your movements be smooth and steady as your breath. There we go. Good. Last one.
Malasana will meet. Hips low so that hug to center.
Take a breath.
Then fold forward into ragdoll pose.
Parallel your feet, drop your head, give it a good shake maybe. Feel free to grab your shins with your hands or clasp your palms behind your back into a bind. Just take a few breaths to hang loose, to shake off whatever has become unnecessarily accumulated. And release any binds that you have. And lift halfway up. Your hands to your shins, heart forward.
And bow as you exhale and pull your core in again, right on empty.
Again, lift halfway as you breathe in.
Begin fold as you exhale, pulling into Vinyasa. Good. One more time. Lengthen as you inhale. Then fold as you exhale, belly tight.
Rise all the way up to stand. Reach your arms out and up. And bring your hands to connect together over your heart.
Mountain.
Close your eyes. Know that you are here.
Trust that you have what you need.
Your breath just that steady reminder if ever you forget. One over. Adjust your hands or your feet however necessary, or even drop your knees into a child's pose. Right, keep inviting your breath in full so that you can call your awareness back in. On an inhale, lift your heels. And as you exhale, bend your knees, look at your thumbs, step or jump between them. Lift halfway. Bow tight and low. On an inhale, rise up, reach. And on your exhale, bow again. With an in-breath, lengthen your heart forward. And now high into low plank, you can step or jump. Upward dog as you're ready to breathe in. And downward dog as you're ready to breathe out. And continuing to prioritize that free flow of your ujjayi breath. Right, like zoom in, tune in, and if it gets shallow, if it gets ragged, make the necessary shifts that you need to make. On the inhale, heels high. On your exhale, bend your knees, look forward, step or jump to the top. Lift halfway. Good. Bow low, connect to core. Stay connected as you rise, a full inhale. Stay connected as you bow, a full exhale. From connection, lift halfway, new breath. Step or jump lightly, low push-up. Upward dog, fill your lungs. Downward dog, empty them out. And then it's just one breath in. And as you breathe out, look forward. Top of your mat empty. Lift halfway up. And fall low. And follow your inhale upward. And follow your exhale into the fold. Breathe your inhale to lengthen. And step or jump, low push up. Upward dog, lift safe, seal the fill. Downward dog, empty it out. You'll take one breath in, clear the breath, look forward, jump or step, top of mat. Lift halfway, stay light, full low, then rise up three more. Keep flowing, sun A, Surya Namaskar. You're just going into your own pace, letting your breath set that pace. Welcome to add on the jump forwards, the jump backwards. Maybe you close your eyes, if that helps keep you connected. Good. But notice your connection to core, to Uddiyana. Sometimes it's tempting on the fill and the extension to lose that connection. I maintain it. That's going to keep you light. There we go. Good. Back to Ujjayi, every time you notice you fall into a pattern or habit or reaction, back into connection again and again. When you finish your three rounds, we will meet in a chair pose, Utkatasana. And you'll just arrive there when you arrive there. Whether you're the first one, the last one, like, doesn't matter. That's irrelevant. Right? Like, where you are, set your eyes. Stay connected or use your tools to come back into connection. And then invite that quality of free flow, much as your breath moves through you. Soften your shoulders, your jaw. Your toes get lighter on the floor. Good. And then hug your hips in, just like you've been doing. That's it. Draw your belly up and in. Good. Now, can you take your sit bones down to the floor, but keep the lift at your chest, right? So you're sitting lower. Good, Anna. Sitting lower. Sitting lower and lower until your seat is on the floor and you're in book pose. Hips down, your heart up. You can hug behind your knees if you need to, right? You can put one or two heels down, or you can hover your arms along your sides. Either way, pick up your chest. Maybe flash a hello over there to the screen. Let them know that you're in this with them. Right? Arms up high, maybe, if you feel a little feisty. And then as you inhale, lower your boat halfway down. Pull everything in. As you exhale, lift back up. As you inhale, lower your boat down. And as you exhale, lift it up. Good. A couple more on your own. You're welcome to reach back for a little more challenge. Keep your toes sparked, right? Attentive through every single pore. Three more. Seal your lips. Unclench your jaw. Good. Last one each way. Into the rise we meet, boat pose. Chest is high. Yeah, right here. Hug your right knee to your chest. Take your left leg long. Mm-hmm. Spark your toes. Yeah, and then just do the opposite. Hug your left knee in, right leg long. Keep your chest up. And now take your right knee to your chest. Listen, lift up your chest. And as you inhale, go to that low boat. Good. And as you exhale, bring your right knee back up. Just a little test. Good. Now as you inhale, go back to low boat. This time, your left knee to your chest. Good. As you inhale, low boat. As you exhale, right knee. As you inhale, low boat. As you exhale, left knee. A couple more. Couple more. Toes awake. Heart lifted. And remember, especially on the inhale, keep your core engaged, right? Keep that connection pointed center. Five. Good. Four. Steady your eyes to the horizon. Three. Good. Two. Low boat, let's meet. Low boat, let's meet. You can have your arms along your thighs if you'd like. You can spread your toes so you can see in between them the person across the way. Keep breathing. Five, four. Three, two, high boat, rise up, good. High boat, right here, feet to the floor, take a hug. So grateful for these awesome legs that carry you, right? Did you know that your core is actually responsible for the locomotion of your legs? So let's work it just a little bit more, okay? Come back into boat, feet out, heart up, toes active, chest up, right? Set your eyes. Good, take an inhale. And as you exhale, turn your chest to the right, take your knees to the left. As you inhale, come to center. And as you exhale, turn left chest, knees right. As you inhale, center. As you exhale, twist. As you inhale, center. And as you exhale, twist. As you inhale, center. If you want a little more, as you exhale and twist, you can lower halfway. As you inhale, rise to center. And as you exhale, twist and lower halfway. Center on inhale. Keep going. A couple more on your own. You can do this with heels, one or two on the floor for more support, or you might pretend that there were tissue paper between your knees that you didn't want to lose, right? Really hug in. Yeah, heart up high, breath steady, five. Good, four, if you're gonna lower, like commit to it. How low can you go? Three, there you go. Good, two. High boat, let's meet at center. Center, lift up, whatever you got. Lower your boat down to a hover. Dare to reach back. Maybe it's a hollow body shape. Toes are active. Breath is steady. Maybe there's an upturn at the corners of your mouth and you're breathing so freely. Five. Good. Four. Chest up off the floor. Look at your toes. Three. There you go. Two. Okay, lay down. Lay down. Lay down. Take a full body stretch. Hug your knees into your chest. Rock front to back a few times. And after your heels start to brush the floor, put your hands down and come into crow. And crow could be all 10 toes on the ground. Your arms are like chaturanga or plank. And your knees just find purchase at the backs of your arms. Right near your shoulders, like all those core planks. Notice if you're holding your breath, right? Let it flow freely. And that's gonna give you some space so that you can
rise a little higher. But keep breathing in. Yes, keep looking forward. Take one more breath.
Then step or jump back low with a shot.
Move through your vinyasa, linger in your up dog maybe, downward dog, wherever you get to meet.
Wiggle it out, shake it out, reset. Right, clear space.
On your inhale, take your right leg to the ceiling. And as you exhale, bring your knee to your chest, cheetah pose, round your spine just like crow. As you inhale, pick up.
And as you exhale, knee to chest, cheetah. Round your spine like crow.
Good, one more time. Pick up as you breathe in. Good, bring knee to chest, cheetah.
And take your right leg to the sky, stack hip over hip, bend your knee. Welcome to flip your dog, or just start to spider tip your right hand. You get a little lighter there, really rooted through your left hand and left foot. It's kind of like a funky variation of your side plank. You can reach up. You can even reach back for your lifted foot. If you fall, it's just a different pose. It's called rock star pose or wild thing. So you let it be a little crazy. You let yourself be led wherever you're meant to go today. Good, take one more breath. Up and over, vinyasa flow. But move with your breath. High to low plank, knees up or down, upward dog. Into downward facing dog. Good, in your down dog, take your same right leg up into the air on an inhale. And as you exhale, draw your knee back towards your chest, warrior one, right foot between your hands, back heel flat, sweep your arms out and up and arrive. Like with eyes set steady, drishti. Familiar with your shoulders soft. And here we are again, the same idea of kind of like that malasana, letting your hips sit low as you dare to go, but drawing them in. Have root support, right? That's going to support your core too. Maybe you can lift all 10 of your toes up off of the floor, right? So you really feel that bone to earth connection. Then rise a little higher through your sides. Good, heart up to your fingers, fingers up beyond the ceiling, up towards the stars. Take a breath. And as you exhale, hands to the floor, core plank. Pick up your right knee. Yep, pick up your right knee, core plank, that's it. As you inhale, kick your right leg back. It could be high plank or a hover. High plank or a hover, right? High plank or a hover. You got it. As you exhale, low plank. Good. As you inhale, upward dog. And as you exhale, downward facing dog. I know, it's like a little different. You gotta kind of shake off whatever happened before, whatever patterns are there, and know that the patterns are gonna still keep showing up.
And so you have tools. See what you see, feel what you feel, hear what you hear. It's all good. Let's try that on the other side. So first, let's take a breath in, and then go ahead and open your mouth, let something go.
Great, now from Ujjayi, take your left leg towards the ceiling, straight and strong on an inhale. And as you exhale, cheetah, bring your knee to your nose, think crow with your spine.
As you inhale, pick up.
And as you exhale, knee to third eye, spine high. One more time, inhale and pick up. And exhale to draw in. Good, as you inhale, three-legged dog, stack hip over hip. Bend your knee. You are welcome to flip or maybe just spider tip your left hand. Right, so you're starting just to play outside the lines, outside the boundaries, outside of whatever's been done before. Right, creating new patterns, new connection.
That's awesome.
You fall, it's just a different shape.
Good, take one more breath.
Up and through your vinyasa, knees up or down. Remember, vinyasa means you move on purpose. It could be cat-cows. It could be a child's pose. Down dog is where we arrive together, eyes set. Breath flowing. Good. Take your same left leg up into the air as you breathe in. And as you exhale, pass through your core plank to warrior one. Your left foot rooted between your hands. Back heel rooted. And move your arms up alongside your ears. If your shoulders feel really cranky today, your arms could be wider, right? Your hands could be together, but they don't have to be. Right? So you keep making the adjustments you need to make to be free. And then just like you did in that squat, sit your hips down low. Think left thigh parallel to the floor. And then pull your thighs towards each other, right? So you engage root lock, move up. Toes light, take up your heart, lift up your eyes. Reach back a little further as you inhale. Then on the exhale, come into your core plank. Clench your hands. Pick your left foot up off of the floor. Spine is like crow. As you inhale, plank. Your left leg goes back. It could hover or touch the floor. Then chaturanga as you exhale. Good. Upward dog. Breathe your breath in. Downward facing dog. Let it empty. Shake it off. Wiggle it off. Do whatever you gotta do. So just like a little tinkering, a little variation on sun bees. As you inhale, lift your heels. As you exhale, bend your knees, look forward, step or jump top of your mat. Lift halfway, bow low, and get empty. Then come into chair pose. So bend your knees, reach up as you inhale, and then right into crow as you exhale. Kind of lean in, take one breath just to lift whatever you can. And you'll step or jump back high to low push-up. Upward dog is an inhale. Downward dog is your exhale. Good. Right leg to the sky as you breathe in. And as you exhale, core plank, pass through to warrior one. Right foot rooted. Reach up as you fill your lungs. And on the exhale, back to your core plank. Plant your hands, pick up your foot. Plank or hover your inhale. Chaturanga or maybe chin stand as you exhale to upward dog, a breath to downward dog. You get empty, reset. Other side, your left leg. As you inhale, pick it up. As you exhale, knee to your chest, cheetah pose to warrior one. Rise lightly, gaze steady. As you exhale, right back to core plank. Hands to the floor, pick up your left heel, and inhale takes you to plank or hover. As you exhale, chaturanga or maybe a little stand, chin stand, action to up dog, downward facing dog. From your down dog, set your eyes, heavier head. We'll take two more rounds on your own. You can step to the top, crawl to the top, jump to the top. Maybe it's a crow as you land. Take your flow. Two more. Variation on sun bees. Rest when you need to rest. Let it be purposeful and a choice that you make. And show up fully in your choice, in the movements, in the shapes, in the work. If you get off track, if you forget your breath, open your ears, right? Hear that sound, feel it in the back of your throat, let it remind you why you came. Good guys, stay in. Choose a shape in which to fully arrive. It could be crow, it could be a headstand, classical or tripod. It could be an inversion of any other sort. Any shape at all that gives you that opportunity to be an inquiry around your connection. What am I connected to? What am I choosing to be connected to? How is what I'm connected to honoring my intention? Yes, Katrina, spine, lift it down. Start to push into the ground. Move the rest of your body. Pads in it, yes. Yeah, tuck your chin, head before your intent. Yeah. Good. Five breaths in the shape of your choice. In the shape of your choice. A crow, a malasana, a handstand, headstand, shavasana works, right? Like, make it a choice and then own it.
Lean back a little. Good.
Cool. Breathing deeply. Five. Toes aloft. Four. Good. Three. Two. Vinyasa, however you gotta make your way to downward facing dog. downward dog. Walk your hands back to your toes, back of your mat. Grab your big toes. Take a halfway lift as you breathe in. And fold down the middle, Padagustasana. Shake your head. Unhinge your jaw. Let out the sighs if they serve. Eyes steady, whether they're open or closed. So like all of your senses a tool, all of your senses a gateway. It's up to you how you use them. We're here to practice. Then lean a little further at weight out of your heels. Let your chest melt towards your shins. And release the bind. Take a halfway lift as you breathe in. Then fold deeply as you empty. Come into your malasana, toes out, heels in, bend your knees, squeeze in, thigh to thigh, shin to shin, heart up high. And then in your malasana, take little malasana walks to the top of your mat. Little malasana walks to your top of your mat. And it's helpful if you clench your jaw and make a really angry face about it. And then to the back of your mat. Malasana walks to the back of your mat. And you might reach your arms forward, you might reach your arms up if you want a little more challenge. Turn up both corners of your mouth if you want to do some really advanced yoga. Come to the top of your mat again from your malasana. From your malasana. Mm-hmm. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. And then back to the back of your mat. Back to the back of your mat. Your squat walks, squat walks. Really good, right there. Hug your thighs, hug your hips. Pull your belly in as you inhale, rise up. Stretch up. So as you exhale, mountain pose, hands apart, close your eyes for a moment, zoom in. Maybe thumbs to heartbeat, heartbeat to thumbs. Together we'll breathe in, together we'll breathe out. Go ahead, reach up, take an inhale. And as you exhale, fold forward down your legs. Good, take a halfway lift. And create the shape of crow. Toes on the ground to start. Create the shape of crow. So your knees smudged up into your armpits, your spine round like a cat. Push into your hands, look forward and lean in. Take one little lift of your heels and put them down, then move your hands forward an inch. And then lean in, pick up your heels, put them down, move your hands forward an inch. So there's just these tiny little crow hops. Tiny little crow hops to the top of your mat. You're engaging your core as much as you can the whole time. And when you're at the top of your mat, crow pose. Pick up whatever you've got. If crow is familiar, start to straighten your arms. Make plank. Keep pulling your body up from the ground. Maybe one knee gets light and one foot starts to lift to the sky. Like those three-legged dogs. Keep breathing. Five. Good, look forward. Four. There you go. Three, two. Step or jump vinyasa. Make your way through. Downward dog we need. Wiggle it out, reset, recalibrate. Lean the slate. In through your nose, breathe in. Open your mouth, stick your tongue out. Let's keep this trainer moving. Take your right leg to the sky. New breath here. And as you exhale, bring your knee to your chest. Cheetah pose. Good. As you inhale, pick up. As you exhale to your right shoulder, connect. Got it. Pick up, take a breath. Now over to your left shoulder, pick up your left arm. It could be side plank, it could be fallen triangle. It could be superhero pose where you kick your right foot forward and grab it. Mm-hmm. So many options available, and how's your breath doing? Choose the option that supports that flow. The ribs in, there you go, core engaged. Take one more breath and switch hands side plank other side. Other side. And so your heels could stack, your left knee could come down, your right leg could lift up. Both those things could happen, right? Now pick up everything you've got. Pick up your right leg, wherever you are. Good, toes to the high, go Anna, go. Pick up, pick up, pick up. Take a breath. Right foot forward, runner's lunge. Top of your mat. Good. Back knee could be down if that serves you in this moment. Good, root and connect. And when you're ready, lift your arms to the high, crescent lunge. Easy shoulders. Remember your support comes from foundation, beneath you and within you, right? That's where your support comes from. Let the reach up and out be a natural progression.
of that support that you carry. Right, take an inhale. And then as you exhale, pass your hands down through your chest and spin right, revolved crescent lunge. Don't get too cozy. As you inhale, go right back up. Keep your hips low. Mm-hmm. As you exhale, use your core to spin right. Maybe your left elbow hovers. As you inhale, go right back up. And three more. So this movement is coming from your core and really from your breath that your core supports. This works with your back knee on the floor, by the way. Two more. And we'll meet in that revolved crescent lunge, your elbow hooked outside your knee. Your hands can be at your heart or they could spread wide like wings. Wherever you choose to be, like check that breath flow connection right into your sides. Mm-hmm. Now, wherever you've chosen to be in your twist, keep the twist, look forward and pick your back leg up off the floor. Like all these three-legged dogs, just pick your back leg up off the floor. You might wobble, you might topple, it might take a few steps. Yeah, take one more breath and step your left foot forward, chair twist. Your feet come together, you're still in a twist. Definitely still needing your breath more than ever. You can stay or open your arms again. You can take a side crow. And keep checking in. Hips low, heart high. Good, ungrip your toes from the ground, just sit your hips lower. Good. Keep breathing, Ujjayi, three. Cool, guys, two. And now come back into chair. Come back into chair from wherever you've chosen to be. Sit your hips low. Reach your arms high. You're going to put your right foot on top of your left thigh. There's that half pigeon shape again. Right? And much like you did in that very first half pigeon, it's active. Hug your hips in. Pull your thighs and belly in. And sit lower and lower and lower. And the lower you sit, right, like the more balance you're actually going to have, you could put your hands on the floor and put your armpits against your shin. Push your shin and arms together. Start to lean in and your left toes might lift. Flying pigeon. Keep breathing deeply. Ujjayi, steady. If you fall, just take it as an opportunity to try again. Cool. Five, four. Three, two. Yes, Gabby. Vinyasa. Step or jump it through. Make your way. Good work. Down dog, let's get there. In your down dog, bend your knees, look at your thumbs, go ahead, jump up between them and roll onto your back. Lay down, you're welcome. Just hug your knees. Rock a little side to side. Free massage. Let it be rest. Let it be rest. For all you know, it's all the rest you'll get. Really good. And then go ahead and take your legs straight up towards the ceiling. Spark your toes, wake them up. Pull your belly down towards the ground. And even here, there's a hug between your hips, right? Move up, connection. Stay with your head and chest down, or lift your chest and head off the floor. Reach forward towards the person across the aisle. Or if you're over there in computer land, towards us, right? Keep pulling your belly in, lifting your chin away from your chest. Good. Now with your breath steady and free, as you inhale, just lower your right leg down to a hover. And as you exhale, lift it up. As you inhale, left leg down to a hover. As you exhale, lift it up. Good, a couple more, just like that. Nice and easy, relinking connection to breath. Remember, your core supports your breath, even on the inhale, even on extension. Maybe especially then. As you exhale, could you lift your chest even higher, right? And then just keep it lifted. Five, mm-hmm. Four, soften your jaw, breath flow. Three, two, we'll meet in the hover. Stretch your pose, arms along your side, do your hands at your thighs, or you can reach back, think hollow body, and breathe deeply. Five, four, three, two, now come into boat pose. Lift up, your old friend. Take an inhale, let a breath out, and as you inhale, lower back down, low boat. And as you exhale, lift back up, high boat. Just three more, and I know you can do anything for three breaths. Three more. You really can, and it starts with you believing it, though. It doesn't matter if I believe it. Like, it helps, but it matters most if you do. There you go, good. Last one, last one. Good, high boat, we meet. High boat, high boat. Take a breath. Feet on the floor, hug your knees. We
them in, behind your spine, give a little love. Okay, back into boat, last time maybe. Heels up, heart up, set your gaze,
unclench your jaw. Good, as an inhale, lower your bow down to a hover.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and maybe you reach back, maybe you spread your toes out wide enough that you can see through them. Keep breathing, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, lay down to the floor. Full body stretch available, don't miss it. Hug your knees into your chest. Here we go, last thing. Feet up into the air, right back up. Right back up. Toes flexed or flointed, but your feet super duper awake and active. Good, and then go ahead and leave your chest down or lift your chest up off of the floor and take your hands and interlace them like, let's go with Han Solo, blaster style. Lift your chest up. Yeah, keep pulling your belly in, chin away from your chest. Go ahead and take a breath. And then as you exhale, lower your right leg down to a hover and twist to the left. Pick up both of your shoulders off the floor. And now as you inhale, back up to center, stay lifted. As you exhale, left leg lowers, twist right. And as you inhale, center, stay lifted. As you exhale, twist. As you inhale, center. As you exhale, twist. Keep going at your own pace. The breath leads the way and your core supports your breath's flow. 10, 9, 8, feet active. 7, 6, good, 5, 4, 3, 2, and now whichever twisted side you're on, just stay there, bring both of your legs down to a hover, still in your twist, both of your legs down to a hover, still in your twist, smiling helps, keep breathing, 5, 4, 3, 2, other side, twist, keep breathing, 5, 4, 3, 2, down the middle, arms at your sides, you really can, set your eyes, we have 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, lay down. Take a full body stretch. Hug your knees into your chest. Rock front to back along your spine. Since you're so familiar with crow, maybe you roll right up into it. Right hands to the floor and you lift what you've got. Gaze steady as she goes to the horizon in front of you. Here again, an opportunity, since you've done so many cheetah poses, maybe start playing in your crow, one knee to your chest or one leg to the sky. Try both sides. One side might be different. Mm-hmm. Lean in. There you go, Heather. Good girl. Heels higher now. 5. Go in. Lean in. 4, 3, 2. Vinyasa. Good job. Make your way through. Down dog. Shake it out. Reset. New moment. Right? New beginning. Clear your breath in. Roar it out. Okay. Left leg high. Full inhale. As you exhale, knead your chest, cheetah. Love this pose, right? Kick up. Take a breath in. As you exhale to your left shoulder, connect. Mm-hmm. As you inhale, kick up. Then over to your right shoulder, you're going to pick your right arm up. And whatever you do with your left leg is up to you. You could put your knee down, your foot down, fall in triangle, side plank. Right, you could grab your knee or your foot, superhero pose. Then lift from the floor. Yeah, maybe you dare to look up. Take one more breath, switch hands, side plank, other side. Other side. Yeah, adjust what you need to adjust. You have foundation, right? Beneath you, connection within you, rise from it. Yeah, hips set up, heart up, top leg up, top leg up, take a breath. Step it up, runner's lunge, top of your mat. Mm-hmm. Yeah, ground and settle first. Adjust your stance however you need to. And then rise from it, high crescent lunge. Easy shoulders. Right, soften through your cheeks. And sit nice and deep in your lunge. It's the same thing, right? You're hugging mula, connection at root. Take an inhale up your side. And as you exhale, spin to the left, revolve crescent. Back up center as you inhale, use your core. And as you exhale, back down to the left, twist. Take 3 more. Your arm doesn't have to touch your knee, by the way, on these. It could hover if you're so very connected. Right, see how deep deep you can make it just by trusting your core, by using your breath instead of brute force. Last one.
Into the twist.
Yeah, stay or take your arms out wide. Back me up or down, it's up to you. Make space for your breath to flow in your sides,
regardless. You know, keep the twist and your breath. Look forward and pick your back leg up off the floor.
Pick your back leg up. Yep, and it might take a billion attempts. Pick your back leg up, good. And chair twist. Step your right foot to meet your left, sit low and stay in the twist. Bring your breath back and full if it got shallow. Could be a side crow, hands to the floor. Fallen angel, another variation of an arm balance. It might just be that you bring your hips to your heels. See how low you can sit. Breathing five.
Good, four, hips lower, hips lower.
Three,
good, keep going, girl.
Two, good, vinyasa, flow it out, let it go. Downward dog, we be there. All right, let's open some things up. You're so very connected to your core. Let's use that to do some really big things now. Take a breath in through your nose. Go ahead, open your mouth. From Ujjayi, right leg to the high. Good, stack hip over hip. Bend your knee, and here again, you choose to spider tip your right hand. Maybe you flip your dog, or perhaps you reach up and grab whatever you can grab. Toes, shin, pants leg. Like you can touch the ceiling, maybe. Good. Take a full inhale. Three-legged dog up and over. Let's meet there. Right leg back up. Take a breath in. Bring your knee to your nose, cheetah pose. Putting it together. As you inhale, kick up. You can right shoulder connect, empty out. One more time, kick up. To your left shoulder, connect. Left arm high, up to you. Fallen triangle, side plank. Superhero pose. An opportunity to let it get a little messy and just see what happens if you go there, that place you feel called to go. Good, one more breath, friends. Side plank, other side. Left hand down, right arm high, pick your right leg up. Again, you might reach back and grab your foot or your knee or your toes. You might put your left knee down so you can do that very thing. Good, take one more breath. Right foot to the top of your mat. Let's meet there. Back heel flat. A pause, back heel flat, root into your feet, rise up warrior two. And not losing connection just because you're opening and expanding, right? But utilizing that connection. So maybe you can sit a little lower and remain in sensation, come what may. Straighten your front leg, Trikonasana, triangle pose. Because you're using your core so much today, you don't have to go to the floor. You don't actually need the block either. Slide your hand up your shin a little more, and then lift your chest up. Other way, go up. Yeah. Yeah, your bottom hand could hover even. It could come to your heart or reach forward. Even more. There we go, yeah. Beautiful breath in. Warrior two, rise up. Flip your front palm, peaceful warrior, reach up and back. Side angle pose, your right hand to the inside of your right ankle, could be on fingertips, could be hovering. Top arm over your head, extend. Good, keep turning your chest open. You're welcome to take a bind if you like, a half bind or full bind. Right, not as something to do, but somewhere to explore. Yeah, some of you coming into a bird of paradise, absolutely hop your back foot forward and see what happens. You pick your right leg up. Good, steady breath. Free flow, yes, Michelle. Good, we're gonna meet in warrior two. And so if you've got the bind, you might keep it and step all the way back through. Yes, warrior two, we arrive. Settle in, unhinge your jaw. Reverse triangle, straighten your front leg, reach up. Get long, get lifted and free. Good, half moon. Pass through warrior two, pick your back leg up. And open up, like all these side planks, like all of these variations that you've been playing in, okay, just a different orientation, new way to play. Chopasana, if you'd like, grab your shin, your ankle. Good, turn your gaze up with whatever you've got. But take one more breath, come into chair, plant your feet, sit in, here we go, right.
Right ankle over left thigh. One more time, standing pigeon. It's a new leg to stand on. It's a new opportunity. You get to get off that leg that's been working. Right, give it a stretch, sit low. Your right heel over your left. You can stay, you can turn it into flying pigeon again. You could also put your right knee on your right shoulder and turn it into a one-legged crow. Right, left leg lifts, right heel lifts. Yeah, keep breathing, friends. You need your breath now more than ever. 5-4. In a little, there we go, Lauren. 3-2, vinyasa. Step or jump, make your way. Downward dog. Okay, child's pose, super brief though. Take the rest, take the rest. Stay sweaty, stay thirsty. Let your clothes continue to be a hot mess. Drop your head on the ground and take your rest. It's like when you climb a mountain, right? Or run a race. My husband likes to share this story about our first ever obstacle course race that we did. It was called Rugged Mania. And it was only a 5K, it was 3 miles. But because I was so excited, I ran the entire thing. And he had to keep up the entire time. And then we months later did an 8 mile one, and he was like, that one was so much easier because you were taking it so much slower. Like you were pausing. So right, take the pauses so you can continue in a steady and easeful way. Right, reassess your connection to breath. The center. And then downward facing dog. Let's go. In your downward dog, gaze set, breath flows. Putting it all together, left leg high. Here's your inhale. As you exhale, stack hip over hip. Bend your knee and just play. Explore. It doesn't matter what you did the last time. It matters what you do now, and more importantly, why. Or how, the approach. Let it serve you. There you go. Take one more breath. Lovely, guys. Three-legged dog from wherever you are. Just work it out. Left leg back up on your inhale. Knee to your chest, cheetah pose. Hug in. To the high, pick up and fill. To your left shoulder, connect. One more time, pick up. Good, to your right shoulder, connect, right arm high. Could be side plank, fallen triangle. You can grab your foot, turn it into an arm balance, Visva Mitrasana. Good, still with connection, move up. That's it, one more breath. Switch hands, side plank, other side. Your left leg might never touch the ground. Your right knee could touch the ground though. Yeah, take your left leg way up in the air. That's it, Heather. Now maybe you look up. Yes, yes, there it is. Take one more breath. Left foot forward, step forward. Back heel flat, get grounded. Just get grounded. Warrior two, windmill up. Steady your eyes. Soften it. Easy flow. Triangle. Straighten your front leg, lean in. Your left hand doesn't have to touch your shin, it might hover. Gaze up high. There you go. Lean back a little so your heart space opens. That's it. One more breath. Good. Through warrior two to peaceful warrior, take your stretch up and open. Side angle. Slide in. Nice and low in your lunge. Low with your hips. You've done all this work to open them and maintain that support, right? Even as they open. Take a bind, a half bind, a bird of paradise if you'd like. And this works, by the way, even if you're in a half bind, your left hand can hook outside your left thigh. You can hop your back foot forward and pick your left foot up into the air. It's still bird of paradise. It still counts. And three more of your breaths. Go, Katrina. Hard up. That's it. Step in. Yes, yes. Go high now. Look up. That's it. Back in the side. Angle warrior two. We meet. Arrive. Gaze steady. Reverse your triangle. Take a big breath in. Right on into half moon, lean in, pick your back leg up, and expand from the inside, all the way out beyond the edges of your fingers and toes. Welcome to grab your ankle, take a bind, take a variation, something you make up on the fly that feels right. Yeah, as breath allows. That's it, chair pose, let's go. Bend your knees, plant your feet. Reach up, the foot you were just standing on, I would recommend putting up on top of your opposite thigh, standing pigeon. Mm-hmm. Sit low, hands to heart. Sit low, hands on the floor like all those crows, your shin on the backs of your arms. Push and pull to lift your back foot up. You can also turn it into a one-legged crow just by removing your ankle off of your other arm. Keep breathing.
Good. Let it be what it is. If you fall, you fall. Right, get back in, floor's not far. 5, 4.
Uh-huh, 3, 2.
Take your vinyasa, move on purpose. One breath at a time.
Downward, facing dog.
Drop your head.
Shake it out.
Take a breath in through your nose. Please open your mouth and roar it out like lightning mode. Come into high plank. High plank. High plank can be knees down, one or two. Forearms down works too. One leg up into the air. Maybe opposite arm up into the air. Helpful to not hold your breath. Your breath is your fuel, right? It's keeping your muscles from fatiguing, your brain from fogging. It's keeping you sharp and clear right here. 30 more seconds. Are you already halfway there? Did you even know you were holding it for a minute? Right? You're just doing the work, moment to moment. Good. Ujjayi, through your nose, head up high, 10. Good, 9, lean in a little, 8, 7, 6, 5, pull up from the floor, 4, that's it, 3, 2, now start to lower, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, to the floor, touch down. Flip right on over onto your back, right on over, and take a long stretch, right on over. Arms reach back, toes reach forward, create a little space. Bridge your wheel, one is enough. One is enough. For all you know, that's all you're getting, it's enough. Rise up. Bridge your wheel.
But not from a lack of support, right? All of this support that you've cultivated, take it with you. So you can rise higher, breathe deeper, maybe take it somewhere new, a leg up, an arm up, heels up, corners of your mouth up, corners of your eyes. Use every breath, right, every moment to imbue with your breath. You go, keep rising. Take the top and consider it's not the top. Keep rising. And keep lifting. Keep breathing. Ujjayi, 10, 9, 8.
12, 13, 14, 20, 22, 24, 5, 4, 3, keep lifting. You still got time, and that's a wonderful thing. That's a gift. Use it. Rise up. 10, 9, 8. You came down, come back up. 7, 6, 5, 4. Then press to the top, and then press a little higher for one more breath. Yeah, now let it go. Come on down. Supta Baddha Konasana, rest. Hands on body. Body on earth. Breath in body.
You in body.
Hold nothing up. You've got the earth beneath you, right? You've got the support. Now use it just in a different way. You're dropping into an embrace. Sink in a little.
Happy baby pose. Grab your feet, ankles toes.
Rock a little if you'd like, side to side, or just let gravity do its thing. Oh, let's take that pigeon shape on our back. So you can put your feet on the ground, knees bent, and just bring your right ankle on top of your left thigh, as you've been doing. Let your knee wing out.
Option to just leave your left foot on the ground or hug your knees, your thighs into your chest.
Your shoulders head heavy. More like Michelle's doing over here, since you've been kind of playing with this, you can take your left leg straight out in front of you, even if you're hugging your right shin in, right? It's gonna be a different way of experiencing your half pigeon. Mm-hmm.
stay on the ground or you can hug your knees in, your shin in. Welcome to you. Keep your shin and extend your right leg forward if you want. Without any strain, without any excess effort. One more breath. Gently release it, feet to floor, windshield wipers. Or a happy baby in between if you need to even things out. And go ahead and hug your knees to your chest. And you can choose to stay just with your knees hugged to your chest, especially if you have anything going on with like migraines or neck pain or whatnot. You might just stay and hug your knees. Otherwise, go ahead and lift your hips up and bring your knees to your forehead and your feet behind your head into plow pose. You can have your hands behind your back or behind your hips. This could be very active to stretch your hamstrings if you push into your toes and straighten your legs, keep your core engaged. It can also be lovely and passive if you soften your knees, let your spine round just a little, still supported by your core. All right, in work and in rest, in effort and in ease. Press the back of your head into the ground so you have space for your breath to flow. There you go. Good guy. Take one more complete breath. And as you exhale, slowly roll one vertebra at a time down onto the ground. It could be a full body stretch. It could be right into a fish pose if you need one more back bend. It might be right into Shavasana. Right, journey in the direction of rest and restoration. Completion. Trusting all of the good work that you have done and just to lead you right here, right now, to this time and space, so that you can soak it in. Shavasana.
into a seed of your choosing. Nourishing breath in and a cleansing breath out. That sound of infinite beginnings, one all. And connected at heart, thus connected at wisdom center. The light within me honors and sees and adores the light within each of you. For within that light, we are connected. I'm so grateful for that. We bow our heads.